Hi, this is Ali-Ollie Woodson of The Temptations, and you are watching VideoWebb.
Now
I'm just gonna walk around
heaven all day. Yeah. Thank you, John.
On the keyboard. God is so good. Come on and operate on us, God.
One last word. I give you all the help and through this song, okay?
All right.
The measure of a man, a lot of people say, is did you leave the world better in this place? And I think not many people, they have that said about them anymore than home. They left a lot. So I was asked to do this, help me do it, remember I'm a doctor, okay? So this is a nice tune, and regardless of the rendition, what a wonderful look.
One of us has a black BMW 5HD C7172. Please, you're blocking the driver of black BMW 5HD F172.
Thank you.
who you are. The melody then moves on. And the life that we celebrate here and now, Norma Whitfield, lingers on. Say, that's a Baptist child. Oh, sing your song. Oh, sing your song, sing your songs in joyous mirth. Oh, sing your song. And someone will ask, why do you sing? Why are you singing? And the classic response, I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I'm free. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me. The sparrow has a story to tell. The sparrow would tell us that music, the song, is more about communication and information. It's more than about communication and information. It's about inspiration and dedication. We saw them combined when we started out centuries ago with the field holler. One slave would stand on the hill and call out to another. Then following that, one slave would pick up the message and carry it on. And we moved from the field holler to spirituals, minstrelsy, ragtime, swing, jazz, gospel tunes, and hip-hop. They're even cleaning up hip-hop today. It will survive because it has a certain brilliance in it, but the language was a little painful. The feelings were too negative. Without a song, a day would never end. And you need to hear that sparrow say, I sing because I'm happy. Tell your story. Tell your blues. But the genuine blues songs always end up with a note of inspiration and celebration. That little sparrow will tell you, of course, yes, you need to do the presentation now. All right.
Songs that made the whole world sing. To hear him tell it, and he always told it. Man, I got over 150 hit records. All this stuff y'all doing, I don't know what that is. That's a big song. Baseline. credits he does have, but he's got a lot. He's got as many as anybody I know. Jeez. My earliest memories was me and the boys, 3, 4, 5, and I was 6. West Grand Boulevard in Hicksville, in front of the couch on the console, sleep 5 o'clock in the morning. We had been there since 6 o'clock p.m. And he would wake us up, finally it'd be time to go. But, you know, he would tell him to run that back one more time. Maybe he'll say. And I said, he ain't gonna play this song one more time. I know. But he would play it one more time. And, you know, when you talk about genius, I think what you have to first consider is working. All we see is a finished product. We don't know about the work. And the genius is in the work. The genius is in the vision. I remember many days, Pop sprawled out on the bed, or laying out on the floor in his underwear. That's it. 5 or 6 pieces of paper strewn all around it. Each sheet with 4 or 5 sentences on it. Just a thought. And, you know, it didn't make any sense. You know, but then somehow, like a puzzle, we put the pieces together. But not just an ordinary puzzle, like a Rembrandt picture or a Martin Luther King speech. It all came together with a uniqueness and a special genius that was all his own. Now you have to talk about the work. You're talking about the work. He wasn't big on teaching with words. He was big on teaching with deeds. You had to watch him. He said, yeah, you can sit around here. I would be in the studio for hours on end and watch him, absorb him. Genius. He could put it together. But just like magic, boom, another hit. It's not easy though. It's work. He's the hardest working genius I knew. He's the hardest working genius I can imagine. I love it. My father. So I worked hard. It's all right. Now I put together a tribute for us all to share together. Sister World. Isn't that a nice song? We are the world. Let's remember Norman one more time. You knew him, he didn't let you take pictures. Got a bunch of pictures. But the worst speaks for itself. So let's watch this video. And let's celebrate the hardest working genius I ever knew.
Sweeter than honey, and it works every day. I'll give you my Somewhere. Now is the time for the showdown. I was born and raised in a slum of a city. It was a one-room shack that slept in a chair beside me. We hardly had enough food or room to sleep. It was hard time. Needed something to eat my trouble. Listen, my father didn't know the media wouldn't go. He disrespected mama and treated us like them. I left home sick of a job that I never did find. Depressed and downhearted, I took the cloud back. I'm doing fine.
Yeah. We thank the dedicated workers who produced and edited the film. It was a superb tribute. Let's give them a hand once more for the producers and workers. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Now, Johnny Whitfield will have a few words. Then we'll have the concluding song by young Christopher.
I just want to say, I wouldn't trade it for the world. And after you, Chris, let's come let these doves out outside in the parking lot. And I mean doves. 68 of them. I would trade it for the world.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. The following the benediction of a moment ago, we'll all gather out for the release of the doves, symbolically saying, he is at peace. Come, Christopher.
This man, he's my hero. Beautiful. Sorry, I think it's beautiful. Thank you, John.
For him and for all of us. We thank God for you, our
Thank you. Thank you for what you've done, God. Yeah. What you're doing, God.
All right.
And what you're gonna do. Oh, 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 oh. No matter who or what we are, we must pray.
Oh!
Thank you, thank you. You're the fifth generation. Thank you. Let's all rise. And raise your number will meet to let the doves represent the summer of the dream. God is the wind beneath the wind, holy God. Within ourselves, our deepest selves, we feel that this blessed life is in your care. Please take care of them. You'll carry on the legacy. And in the legacy, we will embrace the family. We will make every moment in our lives a time of standing, understanding. In your precious name, amen. Now everybody gets a hug. Everybody gets a hug.
I don't know how to call my mother.
Yesterday.
I'll take with me the memories to remind the child of the rain. It's so hard to say goodbye.
Notorious, they got to know that life ain't always what it seemed to be. Words can't express what you mean to me. Even though you're gone, we still a team. Through your family, I'll fulfill your dreams. In the future, can't wait to see if you open up the gates for me. Reminisce sometime, the night they took my friend. Try to black it out, but it plays again. When it's real, feeling's hard to conceal. Can't imagine all the pain I feel. Give anything to hear half your breath. I know you're still living your life after death.
Yeah. can't stop. That's right.
He's home, man. He's home. He lived a good life. He left an undying legacy. He'll always be remembered in my heart. God rest his soul.
You got a good camera. I got the same camera at home. I got that same camera at home. We're here for my brother, Norman. He used to come up to my house when we after we did some record sessions to eat all my food. But it was all good, man. He's my brother. He had to say hey. Y'all be cool too.
KJLH, I work the front page with Dominic DePrima, week out of the month. I also, I teach high school, John Muir High School, I'm an English teacher.
I'm a language specialist, I'm a reading specialist, and raising my 13. I got, you know, 9 grandkids, 2 great-grandchildren. I have 5 children at home, 2 in college, 2 in middle school, and 1 in grade school. I'm 67, I'm 6 months younger than Norman, and I still continue to play full-court basketball. I'm healthy, praise God, and I continue to be involved in the industry. Not only that, but the legacy of our music must continue to be protected and not let anyone just take our music and run away with it. That's one of the things that I'm interested in our community. I'm a village elder now. You know what I'm saying? So to protect our village, man, we got to always be on the forefront of who we are as a village. I'm a king. I'm a black king. And I recognize that, who I am. And I pass that message on to all young black men and our black women, young ladies who don't understand who we are. We need to stay connected to our history and understand who we are as a people. We are wonderful, gifted geniuses. And that's who we are. And as a teacher, that's what I do.
Can I get a shout out for you're watching VideoWebb? Introduce yourself and you're watching VideoWebb.
Yeah, my name is Roland Bynum and you are watching VideoWebb right here.
I appreciate it very
much. My pleasure, my brother.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. I'll probably see you tomorrow at the Hal Awards. You're going to be at the Hal Awards?
Check your camera. After you do him, check your camera, see if all the pieces are there.
Hey, I'm sorry to say, you can pick your friends, but you can't pick your family. Hey, this is my cousin.
You know everybody goes here. Introduce yourself.
Yes, sir.
Tell us who you are.
I'm Donnie Soul. It's Smokey Robinson's nephew. I'm a big, big fan of Norman Whitfield, and always will be, because I always wanted to see my name under the records. I'm a rock songwriter, too. I want to see that name under the records people buy, and Norman's one of my great influences. Smokey was number one, but Norman kind of, he's in there and just took over, but great guy, great guy. And I'm a manager of a band called Cowboy Soul. We do country music with soul. We'll be at the Warehouse October 25th, Warehouse Marina Del Rey, 9 o'clock, Cowboy Soul.
Cowboy Soul.
Country music with soul.
All right.
Thank you, sir.
We'll be looking for
yeah!
you.
Yeah!
All right.
Okay.
Thank you.
I was one of these guys. When I met him, I didn't know who he was, and we talked about New York. We both grew up in New York, and then when I found out who he was, I said, you never told me you were a songwriter. And he said, you never told me you were an actor. And from then on, we were very close. And he knew I wasn't there to try to get anything from him. And I think he appreciated being real, you know. Because I watched many people come in and try to, hey, here's my CD, or here's my music, and this and that. And Norman turned around and go, get away from me, you broke, go, you know. And he said, just get away from me. And I would tell them, leave him alone. But I love Norman, God bless. I'm from Manhattan, Lower East Side. Yeah, I lived all over though, in New York, Bronx. This is my girlfriend, Laura. And I'm Joey Gonzalez. And Norman actually was making a movie with me, you know, before things got, you know, bad for him and we had to stop. But I love you, Norman, God bless. To the family and everybody.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Is it a photo op? Hold on. My name is Milk.
Okay. All right, y'all. Get up out of them chairs. If you're driving, don't get up out your seat, though. Because it's time to dance.
come to him, don't be afraid. In a time, day and night, he can give you what you need. And if you pray a prayer in faith, and in your heart believe it, it's already alright. Oh yes it is, oh yes it is, oh yes it is. It's already alright. So when life problems get you down, can't find no peace nowhere around, trust in the spirit you can't see, it's about to bring you your relief. Go ahead and cry now, it's alright, cause now you're crying tears of joy. This life ain't hurting you no more, cause you know it's
my name is Damon Day. I just want to say I love the Whitfield family. I was up there with Norman a couple of days before he passed. We sat down and we talked about everything, man. He was just a beautiful cat, man. So I just want to say my heart goes out to the family. And I love you, Mike, Johnny, and Norman. And Roland. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is the Witherspoon family. We send our deepest condolences to you and your family. Thank you for everything that you've done for us, Norman. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
My name's Artis Phillips, and I give my best to the family. Whitfield was a great man, a greater talent, and will never be forgotten.
Thank you.
To the family, you know that I love you. I always will. I want to let you know how well you treated me by working for Norman, and I love you all. God bless, and I'll see you soon.
Hi, Ron Barrows. I was a friend of Norman's, had great respect for him. Thought he was very talented. Let's say this, beyond very talented. Was a well-defined individual. Always enjoyed his company. Found him to be open and different.
Yeah.
Open and different. Always treated me good. One thing he did, he always treated me good and always accepted me as a friend. I was glad to be at the funeral. I respect his family. Everybody I met that was involved with him from the family, I found them to be excellent people. And I wish them all well.
Hello, anyone that's parked across the street here where the farmer's market is going on, the woman says you need to move your car because they're going to be locking that lot.
Oh,
You know, I heard, I was in the ceremony, and I was hearing about the soft side of Norman and how he was sensitive. Well, I knew that he was sensitive, but there is also a side of Norman that was very strong. And when I mean strong, he was a forceful man. I wouldn't say he was a difficult man. I'd say he was a complex man. When I first got my deal with Def Jam for Warren G, it was Norman that gave me the tools to go in and do a deal with Russell Simmons behind the scenes. And that's not why I like him. I think his most important character was, I think I was impressed by the love he had for his sons and how he was able to, you know, he'd go balls to the walls for his son, and I think I always admired him for that. So as we come and we celebrate the life of Norman, we should celebrate his music and his life and character as a man.
Now tell us your name.
My name is Ron G. Ron G. Warren and Dre are my nephews. They're my brother's sons.
Appreciate the word.
All right.
How you doing? I'm Tito Calloway. I'm out here supporting the family, the Whitfield family. My words on Norman Whitfield, being from Detroit, Michigan, I was raised off the Motown sound. I went years listening to this music, and it inspired me to become an artist myself, a songwriter. It took me to move out here to LA to realize that my number one idol, because of all of the songs, I never knew who the person really was because he was always behind the scene. But my true inspiration ended up being Norman Whitfield. And I had the pleasure to meet him, get to know him, and get to know his family. And it's the highlight of my life right now. And I'm just blessed to be in this situation. And I give much love and respect to the whole Whitfield family. And I'm here to help carry on the legacy.
Forever.
Forever.
Beautiful. From what I've heard and seen in the music, beautiful individual. Glad to be here. Thank you, Charlotte.
Hi, I'm Charlotte Norman's cousin.
No, I don't think so.
Next.
To the repass here, my name is Rico Walker. I'm representing Doolin's Catering. We will be prepared to receive you in about 10 minutes or so. In order for this to happen in an orderly fashion, we'd like to do it in rows. We understand the family, we're going to go by rows. We're going to go to the first row here. The table starts right over there. Second, then after that completes the second, the third, and so on and so on and so on. We thank you very much. And 10 minutes.
Hey, this is Shivani, giving my condolences for Norman, who made such a big difference in my career and Buster's career, and not only our careers, but our lives. You know, condolences to the family, to the fellas, Johnny, Mike, all you guys. Love y'all. Love to the family. God rest Norman.
Thank you.
Father God, we thank you for this time. We thank you because you are our Father. You are the source of everything that's good in our lives. You are our provider. You are our counselor. You are our comforter, even in a time of need. We thank you for this food that you provided for us. Lord, we thank you for Norman's life, his legacy, his songs, the joy that he brought to us, the advice that he's given to us, the deposits that he's made in our lives, Lord. I just thank you for being you, because we know that when all else fails, we can just look to the heavens from whence our help comes, and you're right there for us. So we thank you. We ask that you bless the hands that made the food and bless everybody that's here and even those that couldn't come. Lord, I ask that you would send your angels right now to bless their lives, because these are tough times, Lord, and we need you. Man should not live by bread alone, but every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. So we just thank you for your words. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
wanted to say thank you to Norman for everything that he deposited in my life. He was a dad, he was a mentor, he was a friend, and he meant the world to me. So I'm just happy to have an opportunity to have been a part of his life and for him to have been a part of mine. Love you, family.
I'm Norman's cousin, Denise.
And I'm Norman's cousin, Cookie.
I'm her daughter,
Nicole.
This is my niece, Lisa. And that's Sophia. And that's
I'm Norman's cousin, Valerie. And that's his second cousin, Chris.
We just wanted to say rest in peace, Norman. We know you're making beautiful music up there in heaven. And we appreciate all that wonderful music you left us as your legacy. We'll be playing, praying, and playing it the rest of our lives too. Psychedelic check. Thanks.
Beautiful. Uncle Norman is the greatest person ever. What a blessing.
Uncle Norman, greatest person ever. I didn't know Norman that well, but a few times I did spend with him, we were very educational. Enjoyed debating with him.
What am I gonna say, man? I've learned a lot from Norman Whitfield. He's a great man, you know. I don't really know what else to say, man. I'm sad that he's gone. I wish I would have seen him, you know, before he passed. I hadn't seen him in a while. And I miss him already. Man.
He's the Norman. I love you. Love the family. I got too many words to say, so I'm going to keep it. Be done. Love you, Norman.
Norman Whitfield, you've given me great songs to remember to sing. I know them all, which is kind of, I guess, acknowledging the fact that I love them. I've all been some years. I remember them from junior high school, and that's the end of it.
Norman, thank you for your creation. You being you is marvelous. And thank you for all that you're doing and the songs that you've written. They're timeless.
Hey family, y'all know this your boy, Grundy Boy. Just want to say I love you guys forever. We've been together forever. Norman was so classic to me. He taught me so many principles I'll take with me to my grave. I love him, his ethics, his strength, his sincerity, his just no stuff kind of attitude. Just didn't take no shit. And I love that. Love to all of you guys. May this commemorative effort just last through the test of time. I just know that I'm always here. Just reach out. I love you. Peace.
Well, I'd just like to say, Norman, he liked to see me do my comedian stuff from The Wizard of Oz. He liked to always ask me to do that for him. And truly, he'll be missed, but his music would definitely live on. He truly, truly was a living legend, you know. Rest in peace, Norman.
Heartfelt, if you miss, you're a giant. And if none of these motherfuckers gonna take it to the next level, your nephew gonna do it for you. You know, you inculcated in me and made me stronger, made me better, made me bigger and powerful. And I thank you for everything. I thank you for being a man of your word and a man of principle. And you follow all your deeds and you led by action. You were all action. And you told me before you were gonna die, you said, Mike, I'm gonna tell him when I'm gonna die. I'm gonna tell him I'm ready to go. I may wanna leave today or tomorrow, but I'm gonna let you know. That's how strong your will was. And I love you for that. And I will always respect you. And I'm gonna take a piece of you and live right here. That's what you're gonna be in my heart. I love you.
Well, hi. I'm Pam, Norman's niece. I like to think of myself.
myself as his favorite niece, but we all were his favorite nieces. But I'm truly gonna miss him. I'm gonna love him. I love him forever. He left great memories for us for the rest of our life to structure our life by. He was my mentor. He was my uncle. He was my second dad. And I'm surely gonna miss him, but the living legend lives on in his songs and in the memories of all the wonderful things he had to share with me. And thank God I didn't get cussed out. I was one of the only ones that didn't get cussed out.
I'm glad everybody made it. I'm sure Norman is looking down and very happy about what he's going on here today. It's a lot of love and a lot of family participation and friends. So I know you're in heaven, Norman. God bless you.
Hi, I'm William Bryant. I just want to say that I'm blessed and have been blessed to know my friend Norman and enjoyed him in this physical realm. And I'm looking forward to seeing him in the spiritual realm again for eternal glory with Christ Jesus. Amen.
Well, this is the end of an era. And I have to say that I'm very, very glad and blessed and privileged to be a part of it. There's nothing really that I can say about Norman, because if you know him, it's about the experience and living it. Being a part of it, you never understand it until it's over. And wherever he's at now, I'm sure that he's dominating, he's doing what he needs to do, and eventually we'll be there to continue making this music. This has been my pleasure, and thank you very, very much.
Hello, Norman, I hope you rest in peace and that you're in R&B heaven. You were the master of all writers, and you taught me an awful lot. I was glad to be with you at Motown, was glad to be with you at Whitfield Records, and was glad to be with you up until you went home to be with the Lord. And may he bless you.
This is to Norman. You made an impact on my life. You showed me love, tough love, but it was good love. Told me that my songs wasn't nothing until I was able to make them something. So you told the truth when a lot of people wouldn't. So I really appreciate you for that and your support in all the ways that you know. May you rest in peace. Love. Shivani.
Amen. Yes. Norman. Golly. Oh. Just so many years. Since I was a little girl. Knowing Norman, but I just wanted to say I know all is well with him. I know he's with Joan and Sister Mrs. Whitfield and Mr. Brown and just all his other family members, and he will be missed. We love you, Norman.
Norman, I miss you, man. I love you. We had another trip to Vegas in us. You cheated me, but I'm going to get you back, and I'm going to see you again. I love you, man. It's all right. It's going to be all right.
My name is Dee McDonald. I'm from the Undisputed Truth, and I love Norman, and his music is a legacy which will live on forever. God bless him, rest his soul. I'm so happy to be celebrating his life today. Thank you.
I know Norman since Detroit, and I think one of my memories of him is when we came out here to visit him, Ronnie Pam and I. He came by, and he took us around the city. One of the main places we had to go was Fat Burger. And with the Fat Burger, it was the best burger in the world. But that's my best one. I'll miss him and love him very much. My name is Teresa.
Did you say anything?
My name is Linda Lee Thompson. I worked for Norman Alfred for about 12, 14 years. He gave me my first break in this industry. I'm able to work today because of the tools that he gave me and the foundation that he gave me, and I'll forever be grateful, and I'm going to love it. I love him, and I'm going to listen to him.
Thank you. I'm Karen. You all know me. I'm number 4 of 5. Norman, you know, he was like a dad, but more of a friend, a mentor, my uncle, my confidant, my biggest supporter since my parents have died. He has just really, really been there for me through thick and thin. And I'm not crying right now because, mainly because of his help over the last 10 years in helping me emotionally become stronger. And I just am so grateful to that and all of the wisdom that he shared with me, and for having so many children and grandchildren, whatever, to keep this thing rolling. And my little grandbaby is going to be born Monday or Tuesday, Kaylin. And every time we've had a death in the family, we have a birth. So she's the birth, and hopefully she'll be a legacy and leave a lot behind when she lives and walks this earth. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Bobby Holland. I just want to say that I came here today to pay respect and tribute to a great man, Norman Whitfield, who helped me in my career. As a photographer, I was one of the photographers that shot album covers and stuff for Whitfield Records. And Norman went out of his way to make it right for me. And I'm glad to say I was part of the Whitfield Records family. And I'll live with him through his music forever. And may he rest in peace. God bless.
Really just a fan of the music, and I read about it in the paper. And
not just a fan, because fans are what brings the money and the sales.
Okay. But I mean, you know, the awesome. I wanted to learn more about the mind and the soul of a person like that that can create that kind of stuff. You know, it ain't too proud to beg. To beg on the downbeat. The other part is like the parentheses of the ain't too proud to. And it's kind of a different way. It was all like sort of turned on its head or something on the rhythm, and I wanted to see what's going on with that. And my name's Jerry, and I just thank you for allowing me to be here.
Those who don't know me, and Norman and I fought like cats and dogs, but I loved him still, and I'm gonna miss him. And to all the sons and daughters and nieces and nephews and cousins and aunts and friends, I'm so sorry for your loss, but he will live on forever in his amazing music and for all the wonderful offspring and family he left behind. God bless.
I'm Edie. I am actually cousin to Norman. I guess what I'd like to say is that this is a very powerfully strong family, and he was an example of our strength, and it was really a magnificent kind of plus to the family to have someone who was known all over the world for their music, and to claim him as one in the immediate of a loving and very gifted family, it made it even more incredible to share that I had this relationship with a man who was influential to musicians, to people who just love good music. And I guess he's will always live forever in that respect for the world, but more importantly for our family. There's all of us here who represent him. This one here. This one here. See, this is all Whitfield.
Meant a lot to me. Anything he told me was important. He taught me a lot, like all about music. I sing, so personally gave me advice about everything. All I want to say is I hope he's in a better place, and I'm glad that he is. Love you.
Grandpa, it's your grandson. I love you, man. I love you, man. Thank you for having me, man. Thank you.
Imagine that. That the maker would take a king at the time that he took him. But it's really blessed, and I was actually blessed to have prayed to take care of him for 3 years before. And I hadn't slept for 3 years, but it was for a worthy, cause. And if I had the chance to do it all over again, I want to do it the same way. Exactly. And he had some incredible kids. I have some incredible family. I got an incredible sister. I got an incredible brother. I got incredible people around me. and I'm really blessed that he's looking down on us right now, and he knows that we did our part in trying to make sure everything was okay for him. And, you know, I want him to know, you're going to be proud of me, Papi Sante, so don't get it twisted. This M-Dub, straight from the heart, I got your back, times 50.
Kevin Wilder, known as Calcutta. I'd like to say, yeah, a tribute to Mr. Norman about the humanistic way that Mr. Norman treated people. You know, I met him in a diverse moment in his life. But when I met him just the way I supposed to, when I supposed to. Timing was everything in the essence with meeting this man. He was a good mentor to me, good teacher. Things that he said to me in my life kind of manifest itself. So I love him. A lot of things that go to my grave that we talked about. And I met him in a powerful moment in his life. I love you, Mr. Norman. Well,
yeah, I'm a Miss Norman, you know. He was like a father to me. You know, I met Michael and them when they came here from Detroit when I was in junior high school. Long, long time I've known him. He was an inspiration in my life. My father died when I was 14, and he took me on just like another son. I can't believe he's gone, but you know, he's gone to a better place. His legends will live on in my life, and I know in my kids' lives as well. Man, a great legend is gone, but he's left legends to live on in his life with his family, his kids, his friends. I'm gonna miss Norman. He's a great man.
Yes, I'm Dan Farrell, keyboardist, recording artist, music producer, and from Switzerland. And Norman Whitfield made me move from Switzerland to Los Angeles. Because when I first heard a Norman Whitfield production, that was it for me. I packed my bags, and I live in LA now for 20-something years, and God bless you, Norman. You're the man.
This is thinking about Norman today, how we started out. We were married young. We had 3 children together. We transcended divorce, and now a great friendship. I've been with him for almost 2 months, a month and a half while he was sick. My friend Norman told me in the last few days he was tired, he wanted to sleep. So sleep well, my friend. Sleep well. I love you. Love you forever.
How you doing? I'm Rick Appley, Leon Medusa. You know, Norman was the greatest of the great. So I got to put him on the top shelf. I just want to say God is good. God's blessed Norman immensely with a career that cannot be replaced. His work will last forever. And his sons carry on. They have the talent as well. You know, God has blessed Norman's whole family. I'm going to say God bless the entire family. Norman, God is good.
Hi, my name is Ray Broomfield, and I'm Norman's nephew through marriage, but he was more like a father figure to me. He really impacted my life, and he'll truly be missed. And Norman, we always love you. That's it. Thanks.
Norman was a great guy, and he was cool. And he was one of my heroes, and he worked me really hard in the studio, and he just made me work, and I like that. So rest in peace, man.
My name is Tiffany. I'm Norman's granddaughter, and I just want to say he was a king, loved him to death, and I will always remember him, never forget him, always carry him in my heart.
Hi, I'm Issy. I am John Charles, Tiffany, and Lyndon's mother. This is daughter-in-law Norman, and I just want to say that Norman, you have been more than a father-in-law to me. You have been like a father. And I'm so proud to have been part of your life, to be the mother of your grandchildren. Definitely. I just love you so much, and I know you're in a great place, so I would definitely see you soon. Love you.
I'm Lyndon.
grandson. Grandpa, I just want to tell you that I love you and miss you. You're my father, my heart, my love. You're the rest of peace and your legacy will continue.
Was my buddy. We worked together for years. We fussed. We had a daughter together. We fussed. But I'm gonna miss him. I'm gonna miss that. I'll never be able to talk to you again. Thank you.
I'm gonna try to speak up because my voice is raspy, but I just want to say I love you, Uncle Norman, and thank you for all that you've taught me and all the talks we've had in front of my mom's store and sharing all of our french fries from McDonald's because those are really good. And thank you for all the times we shared. I'm going to miss you a lot. And today was a great turnout. And that's all, folks.
I just want to tell you that I love you, and I'm really sad that you're gone, but I'm really happy that you're feeling better now and you're in a better place than we all will be on this road. Anyways, you do a lot for my family, a lot for me, a lot for my dad, and we all love you and care about you very much. And to the family, peace, like to love y'all.
I was very fortunate to have a conversation with Norman on Monday at 9 p.m. He hadn't been able to answer the telephone for 2 or 3 months. I thought I was calling the nurse's station, and it turned out that I called his line and he answered. And he said, "Hey, Robert, how you doing?" I said, "Hey, Norman, what can I do for you? What can I bring you?" He said, "Don't bring me anything. Just come on over." I said, "I'll be in town in 2 days. He said, "I'll be waiting for you."
Ain't no words to this song. It's Home Alone.
I'm wishing on a star.